So what is going on, everybody? It's your boy Jay Crudet, and welcome back to some more NBA 2K19 My League Rebuilds. We're here today with my team, the Los Angeles Lakers, and if you guys can't tell by the title, I'm doing a DeAndre Hunter drafted by the Lakers rebuild. Now, a lot of people are saying that they should trade this pick for like someone like Anthony Davis, put him in a package with all those players that they're going to trade before, or even trade for like someone like Bradley Beal, or there's a whole bunch of speculation around the Lakers right now and what they're going to do for the second season with LeBron James. But I'm going to do a what if DeAndre Hunter was just drafted and they went along with this guy. I don't see them drafting anybody else other than DeAndre. I mean, people were saying Darius Garland, but I mean, we already have Lonzo. We don't really need a point guard, right? So, you know, we don't want to get rid of Lonzo's potential. There's other news saying that Kyrie Irving might be coming to the Lakers. There's news that every single player is coming to the Lakers, so I'm not going to really even touch on that too much. But first things first, Luke Walton was fired, if you guys didn't already know. The whole front office for the Lakers are a shambles, so I'm going to bring in a sturdy, you know, level-minded Greg Popovich to go coach this team. And with this draft lottery, I had the same order as the draft lottery in real life. Ja Morant actually went number one, and I had no control over that, so I decided to leave it the way it was. Zion Williamson is now a Memphis Grizzly, and RJ Barrett, you know, he's supposed to go to the Knicks anyways. But DeAndre Hunter is a Laker, and we're going to see how good this guy is. You guys already know he was from Virginia. He's on that national championship team, and I think he's like 6'9", I don't know. He's a small forward. He can shoot the three. He can defend. He's very lanky. Like, he can be a great player in this draft. Free agency, though, we tried to sign a whole bunch of people, including Julius Randle, because everybody else decided to just diss us. We weren't able to get Julius Randle because we brought in JaVale McGee. So basically, all I'm trying to tell you is, this whole free agency, we got nobody. We had no players join except for JaVale McGee. I don't know how I messed that up. Every single player I tried to sign, they just would decline it. So I'm sorry for that. But I mean, like I said, this is a what if DeAndre Hunter came. And I don't, you know, I wish somebody else came, but whatever, whatever. We got Derek Favors, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, JaVale McGee all added to the team. You guys see the progression for the players. Lonzo Ball there with the nice four added to his overall there. JaVale McGee goes down one. Josh Hart up goes up four. And we also signed Avery Bradley. Seven for Isaac Bonga. We got to watch him for this for the future. But this is going to be the lineup heading into things. We got Lonzo Ball, Avery Bradley, LeBron James, Derek Favors, JaVale McGee. That's our new starting lineup. I might put Kuzma at the four, actually. Oh, shout out to my boy, Salida M. Gomez. Then we got Ingram, Hart, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, and DeAndre Hunter with, you know, 13 minutes is not bad for his rookie season. Now, before anything, you guys already know Brandon Ingram is suffering with some blood clotting, you know, issues with his health. And like I said before, Brandon Ingram, he's the second pick, but he has not really panned out for the Lakers like how I expected him to be. This is going to be his last year on his contract, so I decided to trade him and JaVale McGee, who I just signed in free agency, for a better center. And that better center is Clint Capella, man. Clint Capella, if you guys don't know, is on the Houston Rockets. Only 25 years of age, just signed that huge contract with them. He's averaging 16 points a game for them with around 10 rebounds. And like I said, he got that four-year deal. I'm okay with having him for 4 years just because he is a solid young center in this league. And I thought I wanted to get maybe one more pick just because I thought I was giving up way too much for this guy. And they do a lottery-protected pick in 2020, Jamario James, and they want me to get Johnny Bryant. And I mean, this is solid. At least we'll have a protection on that pick for the lottery. So we're going to go ahead and do that trade. And now Clint Capella is officially a Los Angeles Laker. Another player right now that we're worried about, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, is unsettled on what he wants to do in free agency. And he also isn't producing like I expected him to. So we're going to trade him for Luke Kennard here, who's in Detroit averaging 12 points a game. Another young player from, I think, 2018's draft. So we did that trade as well. And one more thing we did, Avery Bradley, another new addition, is getting traded for Frank the Tank Kaminsky, man. You know, Avery Bradley, I'm not trading him because he's trash. I'm just trading because he's not, you know, producing, and I don't think he's getting enough minutes. Having all those shooting guards all at once was just not a good fit for him. And we can always use another power forward or center in Frank the Tank, so why not? Charlotte agrees to that trade, and at the end of the season, Stephen Curry wins most valuable player, averaging 34 points and 7 assists. Zion, of course, even though he's not in New Orleans, he wins the Rookie of the Year with the Grizzlies, averaging 23 and 9. Spencer Dinwiddie, Sixth Man of the Year in Brooklyn, averaging 14 and 7 assists. Giannis with Defensive Player. Jabari Parker, Most Improved in Washington. And Coach of the Year goes to Brett Brown of the 76ers. Looking at the All-NBA teams, Zion makes All-NBA first team in his first year, which is insane. LeBron James, All-NBA second team. What do you guys think about LeBron James making All-NBA third team in real life this year, man? I think they're dissing heavily. He could have been MVP. I mean, even though if he didn't get injured, I'm pretty sure he would have been in the race for MVP. He's pretty much in the race every single year. But you guys see DeAndre Hunter had a great year, 10 points a game, 2 rebounds, all rookie second team, not too bad. Looking at the stats for this year, though, Kuzma was right behind LeBron with 16 a game and 5 rebounds. Clint Capella did his thing with 14 and 11 with 2 blocks. Kennard was our fourth scoring option with 10 a game. And then, of course, DeAndre Hunter, you guys know, had 10 points. Their favors, not enough. But we are in the playoffs as a third seed going up against the Denver Nuggets. Let's see what this team is looking like, man. Yeah, pretty much the same team. Jamal Murray, Gary Harris, and except for the fact that Michael Porter Jr. is back. A lot of people are forgetting that, man. The Denver Nuggets made it that far without Michael Porter Jr., who I think could be a better version of Ben Simmons, bro. Like, just wait and see, man. When he was playing in Missouri, Michael Porter Jr. was that guy. First game, though, we end up winning by 6 points there. LeBron had a pretty good game. Game number two, we go up 2-0 here. Great job again for LeBron James. 35, 6-6 with 2 steals. 21 for Kuzma. 20 and 12 for Lonzo Ball. That's the kind of production I need out of these guys, man. I think personally, and it's not no bias at all, if the Lakers were to keep this young core and just add DeAndre Hunter, we're definitely making the playoffs. Because when LeBron got injured last year, Christmas Day, we were set to be the fourth seed, and like we were on a pretty good streak. We beat the Warriors that game, even though LeBron went out. And I think, like, bro, players are going to develop. Kuzma's going to get better. Lonzo's going to get better. Josh Hart's going to get better. And then we add a player like DeAndre Hunter, and maybe like Jimmy Butler, or, you know, whoever comes to the Lakers is definitely going to make an impact on the team. So the sky's the limit for us right now. If you guys didn't realize, though, we are facing the Memphis Grizzlies here in round number 2 with Mike Conley and Zion Williamson. As they come out with the big L in the first game there, we win game number... Oh, what the hell? We lost that one. Tying up the series for them. They win by 1 point. 30 points for LeBron James, 8 assists, 20 and 7 for Kuzma. Zion with 36, 10, 7, 2 steals and a block. Already doing LeBron-like numbers in his rookie year. This guy is crazy, man. Who is that? Danny Green? Who is D Green? I don't know. Game number 3. We end up losing that one by 2 points. Michael Conley with 29 and 8. 18 and 9 for Zion Williamson. 23 and 11 for LeBron. Still not enough. Come on, man. This is a huge game as we lose game 4 here, going down 3-1 against these Grizzlies. I can't believe the king is being dethroned by the prince in Zion Williamson right now, bro. 29 points for him, and we still end up losing. As we are looking to hopefully survive, as we do, winning that one by a good margin there. 21 and 8 for Clint Capella. LeBron with 19 and 10. 18 and 10 for Kuzma as well. Mike Conley, though, still balling out, and Zion is still, but we can't stop either of those guys. Simcasted to tie up the series here. We are on the road, unfortunately, and we do unfortunately take that L. Lonzo Ball, 22 and 12, 3 steals. LeBron with 20 and 10. Just not enough for these guys, man. Zion Williamson, I wish the best to this guy. Mike Conley's playing amazing throughout these playoffs right now. As the Grizzlies advance to an NBA Finals to win and beat the Raptors. First year with Zion Williamson. So just imagine an alternate world where Zion Williamson actually goes to the Grizzlies instead of the Pelicans. This might be their future. I mean, I highly doubt it, but whatever. Heading into season number 2 here, we are in the free agency market as we sign Mitchell Robinson, my favorite go-to center. And that's pretty much all we do, man. We got him on a weird-ass 1+1 year deal for 1 mil. I don't know how it happened, but we got him back. Lonzo Ball goes up 4 in that. Josh Hart goes up 3. DeAndre Hunter goes up 4. A lot of great progression from our young guys. 2 for Kennard and Kaminsky. 2 for Bonga, 7 for Frank Howard. We get another player with a 7 summer. I don't know what these guys are doing in the summer. Taking those steroids, it's all good. But what we decide to do for the next year is bring Kuzma into the starting lineup, and Derek Favors is going to come off the bench as 6th man. Other than that, the team hasn't really changed much. And by doing that, we propel ourselves into the number one seed in the Western Conference here, just above the Timberwolves and above the Warriors. Things are looking up. We're 40-16. And all we got to do when we're winning is just re-sign those players, keep them happy, throw the bag at them. So LeBron James wants to re-sign. He's expecting $37 million. That potential is too high. It's LeBron freaking James. We're going to sign him to another 2-year extension here. And this is another big year for us because Lonzo Ball and Kuzma and Hart are all, you know, heading into this season as a restricted free agent. So we're definitely going to try to re-sign all three of those guys. Hopefully they cooperate and actually take the deals. But the only thing we do here as well is trade JJ Redick, who we thought we could bring in as shooting. Didn't really work out. We traded him for Trent and Watford here. Played in Kentucky. He has not even played a game in the league right now. But he did average 21 points a game, 6 rebounds in college at Kentucky. So we're going to do that trade. And, you know, we can take this guy as maybe a little product to stash away for the future if we keep winning rings. But yeah, they want a whole bunch of first round picks. I don't really like that. I mean, he's top 3 protected. Whatever. We're not going to be a lottery team anyways. So I think we're going to go ahead with that trade anyways. JJ Redick for Trent and Watford. And for our player stats, LeBron having another great year with 23 points a game, 6 rebounds, 9 assists, and a steal. Kuzma, 2 points more than last season now that he's in the starting lineup. Oh no, he's still averaging 16. What am I mean? DeAndre Hunter, though, makes a huge improvement, averaging 15 points a game, 3 assists. Capella with 12 and 9. Lonzo with 10 and 10 on the season. Favors with 10 points as well. So I think this really worked out for us as Kuzma starting over Derek Favors. And LeBron James wins MVP. Let's go, man. LeBron James, 23 points, 5 rebounds, 9 assists, gets him the MVP. Things are looking up for us, man. We have the best record in the league. We have the MVP of the league. This is it, man. This is our year. Dennis Smith Jr., 6th man of the year there in New York. Giannis, defensive player. Markelle Fultz, most improved in Orlando. And Popovich, of course, coach of the year. Add that to our list of things to have us winning this championship. We got the MVP, the coach of the year, best record. Let's go, man. LeBron's smiling. We laughing right now. Going up against Denver once again here in the first round. And these guys have not really changed much other than Nigel Hayes, who's, I guess, a rookie from this season's draft class. But like I said, they didn't really change much from this team. So we're going to go ahead and simcast this one. I have more than enough confidence to beat those guys. We're facing Minnesota, who actually upset Portland in round one there. These guys have Patrick Beverley, Keldon Johnson, coming from Kentucky there. Drafted back in 2019. Covington, Saric, Towns, Wiggins, Jonathan Motley. Yeah. I'm not scared. I'm really not scared at all. Pretty sure we're gonna simcast this one or simulate through the round as we sweep them as well. Right now we're undefeated in the playoffs, and now our biggest test. We're going up against the champions from last year, the Memphis Grizzlies. Now, seems like Mike Conley might be gone. Emmanuel Mudiay is starting for them. Let me see how Zion's doing real quick. He's averaging 28 in the playoffs with 9 rebounds. I'm not scared at all because we have the MVP, right? So we shouldn't be scared. Yeah, I think Mike Conley is gone from this team. So I don't think it's the same team. He definitely plays a huge role for them. And Emmanuel Mudiay is nowhere near what Michael Conley is. So game one, we end up winning 22 and 13 for LeBron James in that one. 16 for DeAndre. 17 and 13 for Zion. I told you guys, man, him by himself is just not enough. Game two. Look at this, bro. We're undefeated right now. 25 for Clint Capella in that one. 23 and 10 for LeBron James. On the other side, Zion Williamson only at 18 and 12. 24 for Mudiay. Can we keep this undefeated streak, baby? Let's go. 3-0. We are going to go undefeated in the playoffs. 16 and 0. Come on, man. Let's keep it going. LeBron James, 23. Kuzma, 23. Let's sweep these guys as we advance to the NBA Finals to face the Boston Celtics. The all-time rivalry has finally come back into fruition. You like that word, fruition? Boston Celtics, Lakers, Let's get it, man. Tyron Wallace. I guess Kyrie did end up leaving. This guy's undrafted from Cal State or California. I don't know who their point guard really is, because sometimes 2K be doing stupid stuff like that. They got Steven Adams as well from OKC, though. Traded him from this season. He's averaging 14 and 12 on the playoffs, which is really good numbers for him. But, yeah, they don't have a point guard, bro. They drafted Cameron Reddish. It's all right. He went 14th. That's crazy. Tyler Hero, they also drafted, because, like I said, no, Boston always has those draft picks. They have, I think, 3 first-round picks in this year's draft anyways, which is kind of cheese. But we win game one by a lot. 36-9-6 for LeBron James. 33 for DeAndre Hunter. Finally coming out and showing us what a champion does. I think he's going to turn it on now that we're in the finals, bro. He went to the national championship, and now he gets his chance to win a national NBA championship. That doesn't make no sense. But LeBron James with 20 in that one as we win it again. 23 for Jaylen Brown as we go up 3-0. Bro, we are going to sweep the playoffs. Come on, man. LeBron James, 36-14. DeAndre Hunter, 23. This duo is looking nasty right now, man. He might even start next year. I don't know. 17-11 for Lonzo as we are going to sweep these guys, man. Let's go. I love it. Oh, there we go. Why? No, please, 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 please. Boston, please, man. Why couldn't you just let me have it? Why couldn't I just have that sweep of the playoffs? You know how big of a broom that would be? If I swept the whole playoffs, the Warriors would definitely be looking to buy it, bro. Tatum with 21-10 as these guys ruin our undefeated streak in the playoffs. At least win it on our home court. Maybe that's why we lost. We wanted to bring it to LA. It's a 2-point game, bro. What's happening? Can we focus up here? There we go. Oh, please. There we go. The Los Angeles Lakers beat the Celtics in 5 games here. DeAndre Hunter, 27 points. LeBron with 23-6. Tatum, maybe another time. But the Lakers are your NBA champions. Just in year number 2 of this rebuild. Let's continue this, man. Heading into next year. DeAndre Hunter came out to play, bro. He had a couple 30-point games, a couple 25-plus games. But LeBron James rightfully deserved Finals MVP. Without him, we are not making it this far. So looking at the draft lottery, we were actually projected to get the 6th pick from Houston when we made that trade for Clint Capela. So let's see what we actually get. We get the 8th pick, which is still a top 10 pick. I'm really happy with that. We don't really need a rookie. But we end up drafting our power forward out of Kentucky, Isaiah Todd. Which, you know, hopefully he'll do something for us. Doesn't matter if he doesn't, because right now we're NBA champions. For our pending options, we're going to decline Derek Favors just because, you know, he's getting up there in age. Not really producing for what we're paying him. So we don't really need him. We have Kuzma and now Isaiah Todd. We're going to bring back DeAndre Hunter, Mitchell Robinson, and Mo Wagner. Heading into our qualifying offers, we have a lot of guys. Like I said, a lot of young guys we got to make a choice on. Lonzo Ball, Kuzma are definitely those, the top of my list. Everyone else, you know, Josh Hart, another big part of this team. Hopefully they just, you know, sign our qualifying offer. Now it was between Lonzo Ball, De'Aaron Fox, and Kuzma. We kept this all the way till day 11 where they had no offers. And De'Aaron Fox actually had 1 year from the Knicks being offered, which is insane. The Sacramento Kings are being that cheap. So we're going to send the offers here, 2 5-year contracts. We're going to give Lonzo a 4-year, but we're going to give him a 5-year as well. And we're going to offer De'Aaron Fox just in case Lonzo decides to snake us. As we get Kuzma right away, but Lonzo Ball is still not budging. I don't know why. I don't know what this is about, but Lonzo Ball does not want to be a Laker. And it's kind of blowing my mind here. He is, you know, happy to get that deal. And of course, De'Aaron Fox is right there happy as well. But he finally comes to his senses as we sign him to our 5-year deal. Could have got De'Aaron Fox instead, but I didn't want to. You know, that's a rivalry right there. We can't. Those two were going at it in college. The Wizards actually matched that offer sheet, and now De'Aaron Fox is in Washington. Lonzo Ball accepts his qualifying offer instead, like a dick. So he declines our 5-year deal just to take 14 mil. I guess he wants to be on a different team next season. Whatever, Lonzo. Do your thing. Doesn't really affect me. As long as we win a championship this year, man. This is our starting lineup heading into things. We got Lonzo Ball, Josh Hart, LeBron James, Kuzma, Capela. That's just that's money right there. DeAndre Hunter, sixth man. Mitchell Robinson, Isaac Bonga's getting minutes now. Mo Wagner and Isaiah Todd, man. Let's head into the season, man. Let's see what the power rankers are saying. We're going to change our system proficiency here to pace and space, which gives us a 4.5 star proficiency. But we're third right now on NBA.com, just behind the Wizards, who, like I said, already signed De'Aaron Fox. They matched that offer, I guess, for 5 years, but they still have John Wall. I don't really understand that. And then another player team that was above us is the Toronto Raptors. And before anything, man, shout out to the Raptors, bro. We're in the finals, going up against the Warriors on Thursday. Hopefully I get this out before Thursday. But man, Toronto is in the finals for the first time ever. Take in how monumental that is. Maybe you have to be Canadian to realize it, but like, bro, it's crazy. LeBron James, we're going to send another contract extension to him. We want him to retire as a Laker anyways. Clint Capella, we're also going to send him another contract as well. And Lonzo Ball, I guess we won't really be seeing you until free agency because you declined our 5-year deal. So you can maybe get another Supermax somewhere else. I don't know why he did it. But yeah, we got to just deal with it. Zion Williamson wins MVP. 25, 10, 5, 2, and 1. This guy, if 2K is saying this guy's gonna take over the league, man, I don't know what to say about it. He might not. I don't think he's winning an MVP in his third year, but it's okay. He's not gonna be in Memphis anyways. Theo Maldon wins Rookie of the Year in Sacramento. Cole Anthony wins Sixth Man of the Year in New Orleans. Giannis with his third straight defensive player. Agbaji wins Most Improved in Miami, and then Popovich for Coach of the Year. So at least we got one guy being consistent for us as we get a back-to-back Coach of the Year. LeBron James unfortunately only makes all NBA second team, averaging 23 points, 4 rebounds, 7 assists, and a steal. Still great numbers for him. As long as he's on one of those teams, I'm proud of him. DeAndre Hunter already asserting himself as our second go-to scorer, averaging 17 points this season. Kuzma with 14, Clint Capella with 12 and 11. Lonzo Ball, 11 and 10, another double-double season for him. And yeah, man, let's get right into these playoffs, bro. Going up against the 8th-seeded Golden State Warriors, who have just been decimated. All they have now is Stephen Curry, Kevin Durant, Jaden McDaniels. I mean, he is projected to be a pretty good player heading into, I think, 3 years from now. LaMarcus Aldridge, they ended up trading for him in San Antonio there. Wonder who they gave up. Probably gave up like Draymond Green or something like that. But this is his KD and Steph Curry led team. Don't really see them doing much. They only were 500 in the regular season as we go past them in 6 games. Going up against Denver for the 3rd straight year here. Let's see what these guys have. Jamal Murray is not starting for some reason. He's coming off the bench as 6th man. Doesn't make sense, 2K, but I'll take it. They haven't really changed much. They have not really done anything at all, so I don't think that's enough to beat us. We're going to simulate the round once again as we beat them in 5. Now we're facing, it's like a duplicate season, we're facing the Grizzlies again here in the conference finals, but this time they have the MVP version of Zion Williamson at a 91 overall. They still have Emmanuel Mudiay starting at point. Jaren Jackson's coming off the bench for some reason. They signed DeAndre Jordan, which is interesting, in free agency as well too. Other than that, Malik Monk is a new addition, Justin Jackson, Rubio. A lot of new additions to this team. Definitely building around Zion. We're going to take this game by game as we lose game number 1 here. Kuzma with 16. Low scoring game for a lot of guys there. 12 and 11 for Lonzo still though. Valanciunas had a great game, 23 and 8, 21 and 8 for Zion. We got to bounce back, bro. I don't think we're going to have a quiet game like that back-to-back times. As we tie up the series here, DeAndre Hunter comes out with the jabs with a 26-point game, 24 for Kuzma, 20 and 11 for Clint Capella. There we go, man. That's all we need. If at least DeAndre Hunter or LeBron James goes off, we should have a chance as we win game number 3 here. Zion with 27 and 6 assists. I don't know how to say his name, gets 20 points in that one as well. LeBron James coming up finally for this conference finals, 33 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists, and a double-double for Lonzo Ball, and 21 and 8 for Clint Capella. Try to go up 3-1 as we end up losing that one. They tie up the series here. Malik Monk came out with a huge game. 28 points for him. Double-double for Valanciunas. LeBron James, 16 points. Like I said, we don't need these kind of games, bro. He shot 7 for 20, 2 of 9 from deep. We got to have more production than that. As we go down 3-2. How was Mo Wagner scoring 17 in 15 minutes? LeBron, what are you doing? What's going on, man? I'm panicking. 30 and 12 for Zion Williamson. Are we about to lose to Zion? Is the throne being passed down? Bro, wow. We lost by 2 points. Insane. Bro, what? LeBron, just a very inconsistent conference final series. He shot 10 of 22. DeAndre Hunter with 22 points as well. Malik Monk with 29. 23 and 12 for Zion Williamson as we lose to the Grizzlies. And they advance to face the Boston Celtics, who have Killian Hayes, Marcus Smart, Steven Adams, Cam Reddish. Bro, come on. That was a lock. Of course they're going to win. Oh my god. They lost a 3-0 lead to the Celtics. Yo. What the heck is going on? Bro, of course it had to end on this. The Celtics win the NBA championship. Doing the first time ever in history, a 3-0 deficit. Jason Tatum finals MVP. I guess he's finally grown up at 24 years of age. But that's going to be the end of it, man. We come out with one championship out of 3 years. And it looks like if the Lakers just draft DeAndre Hunter and develop their young guys, things are, you know, the sky's the limit for us, man. We really have a chance. Especially, I guarantee a playoff berth next year. I guarantee a conference finals next year as well. But we'll have to just see on draft night what's going to happen, because a lot of things can change quickly. AD could be coming. Bradley Beal could be coming. A free agent. It's going to be a crazy summer for the Lakers, man. Clint Capella, definitely not going to be a Laker anytime soon. But Lonzo Ball did his thing as well. He averaged 13 in those playoffs. Comes out with an NBA championship. Last year, I guess, potentially in LA. Kuzma, another great player, comes out with a championship. He's going to be here for a long time. Averaging 14 on his last season with the Lakers. But I hope you guys enjoyed, though. Make sure to leave a like, comment down below, and hit that subscribe button, man. Leave a comment on what video you want to see next or what team you want to see next. And I hope you guys have a good day, man. Raps in 6. I will see y'all in the next one. I'm in the dark going crazy. I'm in the dark throwing 20 past 8. I'm in the dark, it's a movie Scorsese. I'm in the dark, that's how life been lately.